Let's learn how to solve Sudoku problem. Have you heard of it before? Have you seen Sudoku puzzle in the newspapers and wondered what it is and how to solve it? So let's first understand what is a Sudoku problem. Well, in a standard Sudoku problem, numbers 1 to 9 must go in every cell, row, column in a 9x9 grid exactly once. Sounds difficult, isn't it? How do we solve difficult problems? We break them down into smaller problems so they become easy to solve. So let us first learn how to solve a 4x4 Sudoku. So, in a 4x4 Sudoku problem, as shown here, numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4 go in every cell. Each row, column, and mini grid must contain these numbers exactly once. Still sounds difficult? Let's break it down further into smaller problem. Let's start with 1 4 cell grid at a time. Look at the grid shown in orange at top left corner. Number 3 is already present in this grid. 1, 2 and 4 are remaining to be put. So what number should I try next? Let's try 1 as it is not there in the grid and should be placed in 1 of the empty squares. So where should I put it? Can I put it in the column on the right of 3 shown in blue? No. Do you know why? Right, this column already has a 1 in it. Can I put it in the row below 3? Yes, because in this mini grid, this is the only possible place. What number should I try next? Let's take 2. Where can we place 2 in this mini grid? Can 2 be placed in the top row shown in blue? No. Why not? Because 2 is already present in the top row. Therefore, what is the only possible place for 2? Yes, it can only be placed in the location shown in red. Now, there is only one place left in the grid and we have only one number 4 left. So let's put it in the empty place and grid is complete. So that solves a smaller problem. What do we do next? We need to solve the bigger problem. We need to solve the bigger 4x4 grid. Okay, so let's take another mini grid. Should we take the one on the top right corner? Number 2 is already present. So what number should we try next? So let's take 2. Oh, sorry. Let's take 1 and see where all we can place it. Can you see that there is only one place possible for number 1 in this grid, which is shown in red? Why so? Because red second row already contains 1. What number should we try next? Since 2 is already present, let's try 3. Where all can we place 3 in this mini grid? 3 can be put in any of the cells shown in red. Why? Because both places can hold number 3 at this moment as per the rules of the puzzle. So let's tentatively put 3 in both cells. Now let's try 4. Is it possible to put 4 in the cell marked by blue column? No. Why not? Because 4 is already present in that column. Therefore, only place possible for 4 is the one shown in red. So let's clear the tentative marked 3 and put 4 in that cell. This leaves only one place for 3 in the grid, and this mini grid is also complete. What do we do next? Right, so let's take the next mini grid and try to solve in a similar way. So let's take the bottom left mini grid. Number 1 is already present. So shall we try number 2? Number 2 can be put in both cells shown in red. So let's mark 2 tentatively in both cells as we did before for number 3. So let's now try 3. Where can we put 3? So 3 can only be put in the cell shown in red. Why so? Again, because 3 is already present in the column shown in blue. So next, let's try to put 4. 4 is only possible in the top left cell shown in red, as 4 is already present in the bottom row shown in blue. So we clear tentative 2 from there and put 4. That confirms the position of 2. So great, this grid is also complete. Let's now take the only mini grid left on the bottom right corner. Well, this is becoming exciting, isn't it? So if we try 1, it is already present in the bottom row and the rightmost column shown in blue. So the only place possible for 1 is shown in red. We try 2 next. As 2 is already present in the row and column shown in blue, there is only possible place for 2, which is shown in red. So now let's put the remaining number 3 in the empty cell available. And that solves this mini grid and the complete 4x4 grid. Hope that you have understood how to solve Sudoku. Now you can do the worksheet to solve more Sudoku problems in a similar way. Thank you.